There were some other jailers. The Bible said on the other side. They were pleading the fifth. But when God set you free, it's not time to plead. It's not time to be quiet. When God delivers you, it's not time to hold. I was watching news here a year ago when some lady won some millions of dollars. And they show her and said on the news, you shouldn't tell anyone because they will know your address. They will come looking for you. They will come looking for you. But the woman was so excited. She was so happy that she went and told brother so and so. And another brother tell another sister. Yes. And before you know it, everybody know where she lives. Yes. So when God has done something, yes, don't let the devil quiet you. I said, don't tell her what the Lord has done. Yes. I don't think you get where I'm going. Yes. If God delivers something, yes, in your home, yes, it's not time to be quiet. Yes. You're praying for a job for a long time. God give you a job, it's not time for me. Because when you praise God, more blessings will come down.
Praise God.
Blessing
Jesus.
Paul and Silas was in jail.
Amen. Amen.
And the guard stood there.
Yes.
He's supposed to be the one protecting that nobody escape. And Paul and Silas said, listen, we're going to praise the God of Abraham.
Yes.
We're going to praise the God of Isaac.
Yes.
We're going to praise the God of Jacob.
Yes.
Because there's something,
yes,
when you praise God,
yes,
something, yes, will happen.
Yes.
Try it. Stop praising God.
Yes.
And you feel the breakthrough. You feel the problem,
yes,
going away.
Yes.
When you praise God,
yes, something happens.
And they start to praise God. They start to shout. They start to say, thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Lord, I thank you in advance for opening the prison doors.
Yes.
I thank you in advance for opening the prison windows.
Yes.
I thank you in advance.
Yes.
And God alone,
yes,
when they start to praise God,
yes, yes,
the security guard standing attention,
yes,
by the door.
Oh, yes.
God allow a sweet sleep.
Yes.
Yes.
God can do all things, you know.
Yes.
He allowed a nice sleep.
Yes.
And we all know how sleep feels good.
Yes.
But sometimes many of us, if it's not for the alarm, we'll still be sleeping right now. Many of us, if we didn't set an alarm,
yes,
we would still be sleeping.
Yes.
So the Lord allowed, the Bible said,
yes,
a nice sleep to come upon the guard,
yes,
that was watching Paul and Silas,
yes,
from escaping.
Yes.
The Lord put a nice sleep into him.
Yes.
The Lord tranquilized him.
Yes.
So he's standing attention, sleeping.
Yes.
But Paul and Silas praises God,
yes,
behind the scenes and shouting,
yes,
and dancing for the victory ahead.
Yes. Amen. Amen. Amen.
When the security guard opened his eyes,
yes,
the Lord allowed his eyes
to
remove the veil and said, take a look, brother. Take a look at the place that you've been paid to secure. I can imagine by the eyes of faith, he do a big yawn. You know, like many of us give a big yawn when we're tired. And when he finally yawned and looked around, he said, wait, something is not right. Who opened the front door? Who opened the side window? Who opened the back door? Wait a minute. The bars that blocked Paul and Silas was wide open. He said, Lord, me dead now. If you're from Jamaica, you'll say, Lord, me dead now. I'm going to lose not only my job, but I'm going to lose my life. I've been paid to protect. I'm a jailer to protect the inmates. Paul and Silas, they were in jail. And when he looked around, everywhere was open. He grabbed a sword. The Bible said
to kill him,
he took a sword.
To kill him.
That's the security guard now.
Amen.
And he took the sword and said, before they come and kill me, I'm going to take my own life. Because he thought Paul and Silas run away. He's supposed to be protecting them.
Oh, yeah.
Paul and Silas said, 1 minute we're not gone. God deliver you sometime, he going to take you out of the presence of your enemies right away. He let you stay there so you can see the blessings that God has for you. And see how God starts to bless you. And how God starts to lift you up. Because you were down one time. But when God touched you, you start to rise. They said, we are still here. Did Jesus say, where are you? He said, we are still here. Don't harm yourself. We are still here. God in delivering power came and opened the doors. So the bars in your life, the doors in your life, God is saying, he can open them. There are many different gates and bars in our lives. God is saying, he can set you free. He can deliver you in the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Amen.
That's not going to hold on. He said, I've had some good days. But I've had some bad days. We cannot testify we've had bad days. There are days when we feel like we can't go another mile. The days you feel like walking on the job, I said, look, take your job. Take everything you want to go. But that's your feeling. But there's something about it when you think about it. I said, Lord, I might have some bad days now. But I remember there were some good days. When my son was sick and I lay hands on him and God delivered him. There were good days when I couldn't pay the bill and God said that the lady, I said, God bless you. I want to open my hand. There is something inside. There are days when I feel sick in body and God sent deliverance and healing. So my good days outweighs my bad days. Why shouldn't I praise God? Why shouldn't I give him thanks? Why shouldn't I dance for joy? The time will come, and I say it over and over, when we will not have this freedom.
Amen.
We're having now to praise God.
Yes. Yes.
There are many Asian countries that they don't have the right and the freedom to praise God the way we are praising God.
Amen.
Their lives might be taken. They don't have the freedom to say, God, I thank you for waking me up this morning. They don't have the freedom to say, Lord, I praise you for who you are.
Thank you, Lord.
When the three Hebrew boys, they don't want to bow to the idol. There are many idols that the enemy might want us to bow to.
Yes.
But don't bow.
Amen.
Only to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Yes. Yes. Amen.
He's the only one that we bow to. Because every knee shall and every tongue shall that Jesus Christ is the only one we should bow to.
Yes.
Man will fail you, but Jesus never fails.
God.
We thank God that God is God and not man.
Yes.
Because many of us would be alive.
Yes.
The way some of our friends don't like us.
Yes.
The way some of our neighbors don't like us.
Yes.
If they had the power to take our life, they would have taken it. But thank God they can't touch the body, but they can touch the soul.
Yes.
When you're God, you need not worry nor fret.
Yes.
Because it doesn't matter what happened to this body. The soul, they can't touch it. They can't see the soul. The soul belongs to God.
Yes. Amen. 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 Praise
God. The three Hebrew boys said, we will not bow to the idol that the king set up in Daniel. We will not bow. And they said, for you not bowing, we're going to put you in the Lord's call in somebody.
Yes.
Amen. He said, for you not bowing to the idol, we're going to throw you in the fiery furnace.
Amen.
And we all know that fire burns hot. And we say for the ladies, many of the ladies, most of the men don't cook. How many of the men cook in here? Other than myself. I don't see any man hand going up. How many of the men cook in here? Amen. Praise the Lord. So I have some company. Brother Fuller had two hands up. But I'm sure when you're cooking, especially if you're using the oil to maybe fry something, there comes a time when the oil pops, or you might touch the edge of it and it touch your hand, and there will be a reaction. I love burning, you just go like this. Praise the Lord. And the oil burning, you say, thank you, Jesus. There is a reaction because fire burns hot.
Amen. Yes. Amen.
You run for something cool or water. and it, it showed that Mark that you was burnt.
Amen.
It showed that you was burnt. They put them in the fire. They said, for you not bowing. We're putting you in the fire with furnace. And they light it. I mean, they made the fire so hot that even the men that led them into the fire, the heat from the fire killed them. But don't worry about what fire they're going to put you in. If God is in the fire, you can't be. And the king, I could imagine the king looking through his window all night. And you're looking out and waiting for the scream. Because you know when you put somebody in fire, you're waiting for some kind of scream. And when you look through the window, I can imagine if they were Trinidad or Jamaica, they probably put dominoes in there. Because they were surrounded. And the king keep looking through his window at the furnace. He don't hear the screams. He woke up the morning. I said, something is wrong. We threw them in the fire. And we don't hear the crying. We don't hear the moaning. Something. So he decided, let me take a walk down there. See what's going on. When he looked, to his amazement, he saw a fourth man.
Yes.
You're not alone.
Amen.
God is with you through your situation.
Amen.
The invisible God is here with you. And he put the fear of them to be burned. But when they look, he said, it looks like as your foreman, and it looks like the son. Now, how does he know that? He said, it looks like the son of God. Touching him, I said, the foreman is with me. The foreman is with me through my problems. I'm not alone.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
The foreman just went down, turned on his Holy Ghost gear condition.
Yes,
sir. And while they're in the middle of their fiery furnace, they just sit down. And they sit down, they cool as a cucumber.
Yes.
Because when God is in your ship, you will smile at the storm.
Yes.
Now the ship is rocking left and right. He will say, peace be still. You know what your storm is.
Yes.
We all have different storms. We all have different fiery furnace.
Yes.
But remember, in your furnace, Jesus will with you.
Yes.
And you will not be burned.
Yes.
We thank God that we have a fourth man when you're in our furnace.
Yes.
Somebody that cares.
Oh, yes.
I gave you an example when I had my car 3 years ago, my van, and it caught a fire with me, right at American Springfield. I was going to Bible school and I told them before, and I started to smell fire. And I was driving and I was talking to a minister friend of mine, and he said, pull over. I said, no, I'm running late. Till I started to see fire coming through the radio. I saw steam come. So I thought it was my eyes. So I took my glass and cleaned it to make sure. Because sometimes the enemy will come into the farm. But is that really, you know, in the farm?
Yes.
And when I look, I see steam coming through the radio. I said, Lord, help me now. I still driving. I think you should pull over. And I decided to pull over. And when I pulled over, I opened the hood of the van. I saw the living fire blazing inside the engine. It was 2 seconds from the battery to explode the whole van.
Hallelujah.
When I came out in the middle of the street, and I started to praise God. You might think I'm crazy. Traffic stopping, but when God does something for you, you are crazy for God.
Yes.
Close your eyes and I'm crazy, he'll protect you.
Yes.
Just jump around and say, Lord, I thank you.
Yes. Amen.
And if my friend was like, but why are you praising God? Because that's your only means of transportation.
Yes.
I said, let me tell you something. The reason I'm praising God, he protecting my life. The reason I'm praising God, he give me another chance. The reason I'm praising God, because I'm able to walk, I'm able to talk. God is a protector. So when God does something for you, coming down, when God does something for you, it's not for you to plead the fifth. That's not the time to plead the fifth. Call your neighbor up. Instead of telling them something else. Say, guess what? Guess what the Lord has done for me today?
Yes.
They won't expect that. They expect you to talk all kind of rubbish.
Yes.
And they said, what? The Lord delivered my child. The Lord gave me a job. The Lord set my house free. I couldn't pay the rent, but the Lord provided it. So praising God. Praise God with me. You pick up the phone and call another friend.
Amen.
I said, look what the Lord has done.
Yes.
There was a brother home that didn't look too right before you know the Lord. Pants have lots of holes in there and stuff like that. But one Saturday night he got saved. And the Sunday morning, you should see him walking to church with his Bible under his arm. Before he had a machete under his arm. But when the Lord changed you, he changed you from the inside out. And you might not believe it, but you look different. Your appearance is, there's a glow when you have Jesus on the inside that the world can't give and the world can't take.
Yes, amen.
Have you ever walked in down and you see somebody come in and say, you know what? That brother and sister look like a Christian. The mark of God is on that person's life. Without anything, you could almost walk and say, God bless your brother. Because the mark of God is here.
Yes, sir.
He changed your talking. You could be talking to somebody, and the person said, bless your brother, have a nice day. And just in your conversation, you could feel God. Because he changed your walk, he changed your talk, he changed your look, he changed the way you think, he changed you from the inside out. I've never seen a tangerine tree bearing mangoes. Or a mango tree bearing orange. When we have the engrafted tree, if you all know what I'm talking about. You could get the orange tree and you could cut a branch and cut the bark and stick it in. So one tree will bear sweet and sour orange. So it's not a real tree. But we want to be real for God. If we're sweet, we're sweet. If we're sour, we're sour. In between, it spews out of his mouth. But thank God that there was a fourth man in the fire.
Yes.
And during your fiery furnace, remember, if God is in your fire, you can't be burned. Give God some praise. Give him some praise. Oh, glory. I didn't even touch my sermon. Stand to your feet and give God some praise. Give him some honor, some glory.